Welcome to Juniper KBTV SRX series. This video provides a demonstration on how to configure a chassis cluster on a pair of SRX650 devices. Refer to KB15503 for text version of these instructions. This video will provide an overview of cluster topology, identify cluster prerequisites, show interfaces and cabling guidelines, provide step-by-step Junos commands to configure the cluster, and use Junos commands to verify cluster status. Here is the topology diagram for this configuration example. It is helpful to point out the interfaces that we will be configuring. Interface GE0/0/1 is always used as control link when clustering SRX650 devices. GE0/0/2 interface will be used as fabric or data link in this example. GE2/0/0 interfaces will be defined in the untrust zone and form redundancy interface REDUNDANCY 0.0. GE2/0/1 interfaces will be defined in the trust zone and form redundancy interface REDUNDANCY 1.0. Prerequisites. In the SRX configuration, any existing configuration associated with the interfaces that will be transformed into FXP0 for the outer band management and FXP1 for control link must be removed. For SRX650, these interfaces will be GE0/0/0 and GE0/0/1. GE0/0/0 will be mapped to FXP0 for auto band management, and GE0/0/1 will be mapped to FXP1 for the control link. Next, confirm that the hardware on both devices is the same. Verify using show chassis hardware command on both the nodes. Next, confirm that the software on both standalone devices is the same Junos OS version. Verify using show version command on both the nodes. And last, confirm that the license keys are same on both the devices. Verify using show system license command on both the nodes. Though there is no separate license for chassis cluster, however, both firewalls must have identical features and license keys enabled or installed. Step 1. Connect control and fabric links between the nodes. The control and fabric links are back-to-back connections between the devices forming the cluster. On the SRX650 device, control link or FXP1 is GE0/0/1. Connect GE0/0/1 on device A to GE0/0/1 on device B. The GE0/0/1 port on device B will be referred to as GE9/0/1 when clustering is enabled. For the fabric or data link, any port can be used. In this example, GE0/0/2 has been selected for the fab link. Connect GE0/0/2 on device A to GE0/0/2 on device B. The GE0/0/2 port on device B will be referred to as GE9/0/2 when clustering is enabled. Step 2. Enable cluster mode and reboot the devices. Set the devices into cluster mode with the following command on each device and reboot the devices. Cluster ID will be the same on both devices, however, node ID should be different. The device to be made primary should be rebooted first. Step 3. Configure the host names and management IP address. Note, step 3 to 7 can all be performed on the primary device and they will be automatically copied over to the secondary device when a commit is done in step 8. To set up device specific configurations such as host names and management IP addresses which are specific to each device, we can use group configuration. The apply groups command is required so that the individual configs on each node is set. Step 4. Configure the fab links. For this example, we will use GE0/0/2 interfaces for fab link. Fab 0 is the data link interface for node 0. For our example, we will be assigning GE0/0/2 to fab 0. Fab 1 is the data link interface for node 1 and we are assigning GE9/0/2 to Fab 1. Step 5. Configure redundancy groups 0 and 1. Set up redundancy group 0 for the routing engine failover properties. Also set up redundancy group 1 to define the failover properties for the interfaces. All revenue interfaces will be part of one redundancy group in this example. Step 6. Configure interface monitoring. Monitoring the health of the interfaces is one way to trigger redundancy group failover. Step 7. Configure REDUNDANCY interfaces. First, make sure to set up your max number of redundant interfaces defined. Start configuring redundant interface REDUNDANCY 1 by assigning physical interfaces GE2/0/1 and GE11/0/1. Next, we assign REDUNDANCY 1 interface to redundancy group 1 and then we assign an IP address to REDUNDANCY 1 interface. Now we configure redundant interface REDUNDANCY 0 by assigning physical interfaces GE2/0/0 and GE11/0/0 to REDUNDANCY 0. Then we assign REDUNDANCY 0 interface to redundancy group 1 and we assign an IP address to REDUNDANCY 0 interface. Next, add REDUNDANCY interfaces to the security zones. Step 8. Commit and the changes will be copied to device B. Verify chassis cluster is up. Run the command show chassis cluster status to check the current status of the chassis cluster. When a chassis cluster is up, you will see a cluster ID. In this example, it is 1. You will see redundancy group 0, with the node 0 and node 1 listed along with their priorities. You will also see redundancy group 1 with the node 0 and node 1 listed. If do not see something like this and the cluster is not up, refer to chassis cluster resolution guide in the troubleshooting section. Troubleshooting. For troubleshooting, refer to the chassis cluster resolution guide in KB21905 at kb.juniper.net. It contains configuration and upgrade articles as well as resolution guide and step-by-step troubleshooting for chassis cluster not up, chassis cluster not failing over, and can't manage chassis cluster. Refer to KB15503 on kb.juniper.net for text version of this video. Be sure to check out other videos at www.juniper.net/support/video. If further assistance is needed, please visit our support site at www.juniper.net/support. Thanks for watching.